Sit down. The book of Luke, the first chapter, Luke 39. Oh, we gonna have a good time over here. High five three people and say increase. High five one more, say favor, overflow. Tell somebody, look at me, it's on me, it's on me, it's on me. God's getting ready. You know what God's getting ready to do? He's getting ready to give you favor that they can see on your life. The Bible says when the children of Israel came out of Egypt, God gave them favor that they could see. Touch your neighbor, say, neighbor, it's on me. I hear the Lord saying, Bishop, it's time to take the people in. It's time to take them in to a place that's flowing. Y'all ain't saying nothing. No interruptions. But this is a blessed people that you're taking into the land. All right. In the book of Luke, the first chapter, glad to have some of my spiritual children here all the way from Delaware. Go to the 39th verse. Every now and then just hit E flat. I'm a sanctified Baptist preacher. And Mary arose in those days and went into the hill country with haste into a city of Judah, and entered into the house of Zacharias and saluted Elizabeth. And it came to pass that when Elizabeth heard the salutation of Mary, the babe leaped. Obasha, Iradamasha, the baby leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Ghost. And she spoke with a loud voice and said, blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb. And whence this to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me. Here we go. And blessed is she that believe, for there shall be a performance of those things which were told of her from the Lord. And Mary said, my soul doeth magnify the Lord, and the word of the Lord is blessed. Look at somebody and say, neighbor, if you could just give me a little bottom, give me a little bottom. Look at somebody and say, neighbor, in the month of May, there shall be a performance. Touch somebody and say, neighbor, there's going to be a performance of those things which God told you. If he told it to you, hold on. I'm going to prove it to you now. Now, who you say you perform with?
Jonathan Butler.
Jonathan Butler. All right. Well, you can say you perform with Greg Davis. Now, that may not mean much to you right now, but I'm getting ready to bring you to Detroit to be on the Word Network to 90 million homes in 200 countries. So now add to your testimony that there shall be a performance. Tell your neighbor, God is connecting the dots. Hold on. God, sit down. I knew y'all would be crazy like your leader. God is connecting the dots in the month of May. Stuff, y'all ain't saying nothing. Stuff that seemed like it wasn't gonna work. The devil should have killed you yesterday. Hold on. Because you have now entered into a month where God is about to perform. He's about to bag up what he said. He's about to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we could ask or think according to the power. Look at somebody and say, neighbor, everything that's on your life, it is about to come to pass. God is about to fulfill every dream. God is about to fulfill every vision. Every setback, sir, was a setup for your comeback. Shake your neighbor's hand and say, there shall be a performance. Look at somebody and say, a performance. This month is strategic where God is taking you. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Touch somebody and say, strategic. You are in the right place at the right time. The sound is good right now. Look at somebody and say, I'm in the right place at the right time. The devil want to make you think that you will never, ever get past where you are. But the devil is a liar. Everything that has happened, everybody that's been removed out of your life, everybody that's in your life right now is where they're supposed to be. Everybody is in their rightful place. Look at somebody and say, neighbor, everybody is in their right. Look at them and say, neighbor, everybody is in their rightful place and all is well. Give God praise for where you are. Stop complaining. I got 26 minutes. Stop complaining about where you are. You are in the right place for God to visit you. God is about to visit your dreams. God is about to visit your vision. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Those nights that you're staying awake, it is not what you ate. It is not the devil. But God is trying to get something to your memory. He's trying to download to you where you're about to go. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm getting a spiritual download. God is taking me where I never been, to get what I never had, to meet folk that I never met. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, he's working behind the scenes. Let me slow down. The reason why you're nervous is because you don't understand what he's doing. And that's where God wants you at. Because this next miracle, it all ain't saying nothing. This next miracle, the reason why folk couldn't help you, the reason why folk wouldn't help you, is because nobody is going to get the credit. He said, y'all ain't saying nothing. For the next thing that I'm doing in your life, I'm going to get the credit. I'm going to give birth to it. I'm going to give birth to it. I'm going to conceive it in your life. Shake your neighbor's hand one more time and say, neighbor, ain't nothing you can do with this. You can't even mess this up. You can't even mess it up. You can't even get involved in it because it's a God thing. You're holding a God thing. You're carrying a God thing. You're walking in a God thing. You're getting ready to deliver a God thing. Touch your neighbor, look on your road and say, neighbor, everybody on my road is getting ready to conceive, carry, and deliver a God thing. Get on your feet and shout. Sit down. The glory is on him, y'all. The glory is on him. Look at somebody and say, neighbor, there shall be a performance. I want to talk to 20 folk that's been tired of getting the promise but never receiving the fulfillment. I just said something. I want to talk to some folk that there's a prophecy on their life. Hold it. Hold my glasses, girl. Don't get, come on. Look at somebody and say, there's a prophecy on me. Y'all, the man of God didn't lie. The woman of God didn't lie. Y'all ain't saying nothing. God did not lie. God is not a man that he should. I'm going over here because y'all acting funny now. God is not a man that he should lie. If God said it, hey, glory. All you have to do is walk it out. Touch your neighbor and say, walk it out. The steps of a good man, they're what? They're ordered by the Lord. We're moving from promise to possession. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, y'all ain't gonna be able to write this. You're gonna have to buy the CD. Touch somebody and say, neighbor, I'm moving from promise to possession. I'm moving from what he said to what he got. I'm moving from praying to receiving. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I'm moving from faith to believe. I'm believing what I... The Bible says, y'all sit down, y'all embarrassing me. The Bible says in the book of Luke, the first chapter, the angel shows up to a woman by the name of Mary. Are y'all with me? Mary, she is a young teen, and the angel announces to her, Mary, you are with child. Touch your neighbor, say, neighbor, we're going to stop right there, because I have come all the way from Detroit as the angel of the day, y'all ain't saying nothing, to announce to you that you are pregnant. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Pregnant with possibilities. Pregnant with new dreams. Not pregnant with careers, but pregnant with your own business. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm pregnant. I'm pregnant. Men, yeah, you pregnant too. You're pregnant with dreams. That's why you're a little frustrated on your job, because there's friction going. What is friction? I told you, it's when two things are rubbing together. You're tired of your old season, and your new season is calling you. Touch your neighbor, say, neighbor, I've been frustrated as hell, but I'm getting ready to move to a place where I'm not going to be frustrated. I'm moving to a place where I ain't going to hold no man but to love him. I'm moving to a place. I'm tired of punching in the clock. I'm getting ready to own my own. God is raising up a bunch of business owners, entrepreneurs in this house. Can I preach? Should I preach? What I'm going to do?
You're going to preach anyhow.
Uh-huh. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm moving. I come to talk to some folk that sense there's something in you. Y'all ain't saying nothing. But there was, whenever God says something, it is always swirled in controversy. God always loved to move in the midst of our mess and our controversy. She was conceived, but she had no man. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Now, Joseph couldn't even touch this. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, God is going to allow you to carry something great, but ain't nobody gonna be able to say they got the credit. Y'all ain't saying nothing. God ain't about to give the glory to nobody else. God ain't about to give the credit to nobody else. If he bless you, he wants you to say, I blessed you. If he delivers you, he wants you to say, I delivered you. If he saved your children, he wants to get the credit. Shake somebody's hand and say, neighbor, I love you, but I can't give you the credit. That's why God moved everybody out of the way, so that he could get the credit. No man should your glory in the flesh. God said, I'm getting the credit for this. And you shall say, God did it. And then thou shalt have good success. I thought I was preaching, man. But somebody tell him, say, neighbor, and you shall say, God did it. So sit down, Bishop. So Mary is puzzled, because she said, how can this be when I've been with no man? Y'all ain't saying nothing. Folk gonna look at you and say, how could this be when nobody had to help you? Y'all ain't saying nothing. Every step I made, Bishop, including television, nobody can get the credit but God. Y'all ain't saying nothing in here. Look at somebody and say, neighbor, stop trying to get validation from folk. Validation is parking. Y'all ain't saying nothing. You don't get validation from people. You look at somebody and say, nobody is going to help you get here. That's the reason why God left you in a place of isolation, because he wants to get the credit. He wants to get the glory. But how many of you know, I got 18 minutes, how many realize whenever God says something, you feel like you're the only one? Y'all ain't saying nothing. Sometimes whenever God says something, it makes it seem like I'm the only one. But the Bible says, they have no temptation such as common to man. In other words, whatever you're going through, somebody else is going through the same thing. Touch somebody and say, neighbor, everybody on this roll, this is a corporate blessing. In the past, God bless individuals, but this is a word to the church. Dream life said, y'all ain't saying nothing, that God is about to corporately bless us. Whenever God puts a people together, it's not just for individuals. That's why God got to bless your leader, because the anointing is on the head and it flows. Don't you holler at me like that. I got my people with me. Don't you holler at me like that. The Bible says, They are in, shucks now. They are in, I need a towel. They are in, I got it. They are in, they're in the 6th month. But in the 5th month, y'all ain't saying nothing. 5 months now, Elizabeth, her cousin, has been pregnant. She's pregnant with John, the forerunner. Y'all ain't saying nothing. God always puts things in order. When it seems like you're the only one that God is going to do something with, God always has somebody else. That's why you can't hang around folk that ain't doing nothing. That y'all ain't saying nothing. I'm going over here because y'all acting funny. That's why you can't hang around folk that ain't doing nothing. That's why you got to find somebody that got greatness just like you. Y'all ain't saying nothing in here. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, you got to find somebody that's pregnant just like you. Stop telling your big dreams to small thinking people. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, I love you, but I can't tell you everything because you're still stinking small. You got stinking thinking. And you want to know why? Understand that when you're pregnant with greatness, you got to surround yourself with great thinkers. You can't be the smartest one in the room. Touch your neighbor, say, neighbor, I need somebody that got greatness on the inside of me. Just got greatness inside of them, just like me. Because when you start telling somebody what God said and they start looking at you stupid, every now and then you got to test your friends. You got to test your family. Tell them what your dream is. And if they just stand there looking stupid, then you know, nope, you're not the one. Because friends will mess you up, but family will take you out. So not even Joseph understood. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Not even Joseph understood. Even the closest people won't understand what's on you. I just said something. That's why some of you hate going away from church on Sunday, because you got to go to them family dinners. Bishop done been pumped faith in you. Bishop talking about dreams. Our dreams, living our dreams and fulfilling our purpose. Y'all ain't saying nothing. And then when you get to the haterade dinner after church, y'all ain't saying nothing. You still pumped up with faith. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Talking about you worshiping that man. He got all that stuff in your head. The devil is a liar. He's taking me where I've never been before. He's giving me a new way of thinking. He's giving me a new attitude. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, who is my mother? The Bible says, I'm done. The Bible says, I'm a Baptist preacher. I got 3 clothes, and that's my first one. The Bible says that she packed up her stuff, and she went to find Elizabeth. Touch your neighbor, say, neighbor, go find somebody that got purpose in them. Go find somebody that got dreams in them. Y'all ain't saying nothing. It's going to be tight for you to hang around folk that ain't got the same thought that you got. Y'all ain't saying nothing. You can't come here for 2 hours and hang around folk with hell for the rest of the week. That's why you gotta feed your faith and starve your fears. The Bible says she packed up and went and found. Am I preaching? Am I doing all right? I don't want to make you shame. The Bible says she packed up her stuff and went and found Elizabeth. Y'all ain't saying nothing in here. Look at somebody and say, neighbor. Say, neighbor, you got to find somebody that's going through what you're getting ready to go through. Elizabeth was 6 months pregnant. Mary had just conceived. Y'all ain't saying nothing. That's why you got to find somebody that's ahead of you. Somebody that already stop hanging around folk that just trying to make it. Everybody in your life, you don't need a relationship that you always got to fix up. I'm trying to preach, y'all ain't saying nothing. So Mary, Y'all ain't saying nothing. Yeah. Can I use you for a minute? Mary. Shucks now. Yeah. Mary. Come here, girl. Come here, girl. Rush. You know who I'm talking to. Mary. Mary. Mary said, I got to go find me an Elizabeth. I got to go find me somebody that's going through what I'm going through. That can tell me about the morning sickness. That can tell me that I'm going to throw up a little bit. That tell me I'm going to go through a little hell. Y'all ain't saying that. Tell me that many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord shall deliver them out of them all. I need somebody that's going to tell me weeping may endure for, don't you stand up on me like that, endure for a night, but joy. I need somebody. Touch your neighbor, say, neighbor, find somebody that's ahead of you. Stop always trying to pull somebody up. Because if you ain't strong enough to pull them up, what they gonna do? They gonna pull you down. So, Mary, see, let me tell you something. For those of y'all, I want y'all to get this. Nobody walking, please. Nobody walking. I want y'all to get this. Y'all think y'all here at Dream Life because the man and woman of God need you. No. You here because you need them. Thank you for your little claps. Let me say it again. There's something on the inside of them that they've been through. Y'all ain't saying nothing in here. So stop thinking that if you leave, the church ain't gonna make it. Baby, let me tell you something. He done been through hell and back. Go ahead. I'm gonna wipe it off for your mother. Mary shows up. She's pregnant with greatness. Y'all ain't saying nothing. But she worried about what everybody gonna say. Y'all ain't saying nothing. When you done been through hell, you get worried about what folk gonna say. When you done been lied on, treated, cheated, talked about, and mistreated. When you done lost everything, y'all ain't saying nothing. But I come to tell you, rock bottom don't mean nothing to God. Come on, Dennis, you come to work. Rock bottom don't mean nothing to God. Because God make the rock. You can always begin again. You think you just helping me out, but I'm talking all in your business. Hey, Mary, I isolated you for a reason. I let folk leave for a reason. I even let the closest man to you not believe in you, Mary. So Mary, shucks now. When Mary, Adabashi, Edomoshananama, Rodorabashi, somebody giving birth in here. About somebody conceiving in here. May is your month of conception. Y'all looking at her crazy, but this is 100 of y'all right now. I say y'all looking at her crazy, but you conceiving right now. I wasn't supposed to be here on that day. I was supposed to be here. I was supposed to be here May 1st. I came to make an announcement. This is the month of conception. Before you can walk in greatness, you got to conceive first. Y'all ain't saying nothing. She walks in on the 6th month. Y'all been in this building 5 months. Y'all ain't saying nothing. On your way to the 6th month, y'all ain't helping me in here. I'm trying, woman. Your folk is so rude, just hollering at the preacher. I thought everybody was proper like your driver. He was so proper. The anointing is on you now. Come on, Dennis, get it. You know how to do it. Come on, do it for a minute. You used to do it. You got it, man? You got it. All right. Bring my own cameraman with me just in case I knock one out. She walks in the door, and immediately, y'all ain't saying nothing. Elizabeth said, y'all, see, just when you think you need somebody else, you the answer to somebody else's dilemma. Y'all ain't getting it. Y'all will rewind that later. Just when you think you're going, y'all ain't saying nothing, to get somebody else's help, you are the answer to somebody else's dilemma. She walks in, said, bid it unto me. Y'all ain't saying that the mother of my Lord would come and see me. And then the Bible says, you ready? This is how you know. See, he told a testimony about how I was there for him. It's because I had been through what he was about to go through or was going through. And whenever I would talk to him, the baby in me. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I had to jumpstart him because every now and then, y'all ain't saying nothing. You need somebody to speak to the greatness that's on the inside of you. So when they got together, y'all ain't saying nothing. Their babies begin to leap. That's what you doing, woman of God. You're here, y'all ain't saying nothing, to make the women's baby leap. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Not because you had a perfect background. Not because, not because everybody liked you. It ain't about liking her, it's about getting what's in her. Because after all, she ain't for you, she for him, but you better get the impartation that's in her. There are women that's on the way. There are women that's on the way. God has called you to a bold anointing. There are women that are on their way that have been torn, that have been brokenhearted, that ain't all fixed up. They ain't got Louis Vuitton or St. John. Y'all ain't saying nothing. They done been walked away. They got five babies. Y'all ain't saying nothing. They done had two husbands, and the one that's with them ain't theirs. And you are, am I okay? You are to speak life into them. God has given you, I haven't met you before, but I see in the spirit, God has given you a holy boldness to walk in the fire of affliction and pull them out. Give me my iPad. Make it leap. Look at somebody and say, neighbor, do you feel what I feel? There's a leaping anointing on me. My job is to make your baby leap. I'm done. 3 minutes and I'm done. You ready? Look what the end says. Look what she says to her. Y'all got it? Blessed is she that believed. You want to know why you haven't gotten what you've been asking God for? You want to know why every prophecy is just dangling over your life? Because you don't believe. You can't receive unless you believe. And you just crazy as a road lizard to be under this man of faith and don't believe. It's time out for just going to church just because it's Sunday morning. Y'all ain't saying nothing. God said that this month will be a month, excuse me, sir, this month will be a month that you're about to conceive and receive. Just as soon as it's planted in you, there will be a quick return. As the seed goes in the ground, it is going to be a quick return. You won't have to worry, because God said he's doing a quick return. For eyes have not seen, y'all ain't saying ears have not heard. You won't have to wait long. Look down your roll and say, the wait is over. Blessed is she that believe. Believe what? That I got a baby on the inside of you and no man did it. Believe what? Y'all ain't saying nothing. That you're carrying greatness, but I can't see it. It don't matter. Believe. But I don't feel like it. Believe. But I don't know how it's going to happen. Believe. I don't know when it's going to happen. Believe. Stop trying to fill in the blanks. Only.
Believe.
You ready to preach? Believe. Some things are possible. You don't have a money problem. You don't have a relationship problem. You don't have a children problem. You have a faith problem. Your belief system has been messed up because folk has promised you stuff and they have not delivered. But God said, this is not men talking. For I'm not a man that I should lie, nor the son of man that I should repent. I'm saying this. This is a word from the Lord. Hold on. Wait, what you're saying? You say, I wouldn't dare preach a message like this here because I know you're a faith man. 2 minutes ago and I'm done. Two minutes ago. Look, watch this. Blessed is she that believe. She, blessed. So what are you saying? I'm not blessed unless I believe. That's right. That's what it said. Blessed. You want to know why you can't get the blessing going? Because you can't get your belief system. You got to decide what system you're going to be a part of. You will be a part of the system of the world. I don't care if Trump, I don't care if whoever get in there, y'all ain't saying nothing. I don't care who, talking about, I'm leaving if Trump get in. No, baby, because if Trump get in there, that mean I live in an upside down kingdom. That mean while everybody else is crying, I'm going to be reaping in joy.
Amen. Yes, sir.
Come on, man. What system are you in? Because the world system says, y'all ain't saying nothing. The more you get, the more you're blessed. But the kingdom system says, the more you give.
Hallelujah. That's it.
Y'all ain't saying nothing. Blessed is she. 2 minutes, start playing that piano, man. Blessed. We're going to worship a minute. 2 minutes. Blessed. It don't mean I'm going to stop, but play it. Blessed. I'm just teasing, Bishop. Blessed. Not yet. 2 minutes, I said. Blessed. He's so excited. God's about to show up to your house in a mighty way on that organ. Get up and praise God for 10 seconds right now. Get up and praise God for 10 seconds right now. Get up and pray. Shananama. Show. Bobo shot. Matter of fact, give him some dance music right quick. Sir, help. Come on. Help. Come on. Man, don't turn that drum machine on and make me dance and I ain't even got no rhythm. You know what that dance was for? Because when I walked up on this building and I saw this building, my next prayer petition is that God will let me pastor again. The devil playing with me and tell me, you're 53 years old, you'll never do it again. But today my baby is leaping because of you, sir. blessed is she that believe. For there not if, not maybe, not perhaps. There's only one qualification. That you what? Play softly. For there, you're standing on your feet, everybody. For there shall be a performance of those things which was spoken to you. What? Stand right there. Don't move. What did he speak to you? What is it that you've been praying for? What is it that has been spoken? Nobody's walking. That has been spoken over your life. I came to announce that you are in the month of performance. Performance, action. Y'all ain't saying nothing. He's getting ready to back, lift your hands. He's getting ready to bag up what he said. Everybody hand lifted. Everybody hand lifted. Everybody hand lifted. Close your eyes. This is the air I breathe. I'm desperate for you. Lift your hands. Those of you that this word was for you, I don't want you to think about it because I'm out of time. Those of you that this word was for you today, you ready for God to perform in your life? When I count to three, rush to this altar. One, two, three, now. Do it now, this word. This is the air. Move, I need some oil, man of God. I need some oil.
This is the air.
Come on, come on. This is